Hey everybody, what's going on? It's your man, Corey. Welcome to the Digital Dash, where I be giving you guys tips on how to market your songs and get those numbers booming. Now, if you're new to the channel, I'm a digital marketer. I specialize in helping artists like yourself get their songs heard through platforms like Spotify, like Instagram, like YouTube, and a bunch of others. Now, what I want to do today, guys, is give you all some tips on things that you can do to push and market yourself when you don't have a budget. Now, personally, I never really feel like that someone doesn't really have a budget. I mean, I feel like you can squeeze out a little money somewhere, but I get it, man. Sometimes life happens, sometimes things that are unexpected happens, and you're left in a predicament where you can't really spend money like you would want to, and you don't want the ball to start rolling, right? Like, you don't want to kill off all the momentum that you've been building for yourself just because, you know, an unexpected bill came up or an emergency came up. So, like I said, I want to give you guys some tips, some push in the right direction on what you can do when those pockets are looking a little tight so that you can still keep things lit and still keep things moving. So, with that being said, let's get right into it. So pretty much the advice that I like to give out to people who don't really have much of a budget to build themselves up is to double down on their content production, build some type of leverage, and then save, just to be honest with you guys. So let's focus on the first one, doubling down on your content production. So what I would recommend in times that you don't have a large budget or a budget at all is to start studying these platforms that you want to build yourself out on. Start figuring out how content moves on these platforms. What type of things are people doing to manipulate the algorithms? Are they using keywords? Are they using hashtags? Are better types of content working on this platform as opposed to others? What you want to do is really sit down and figure that out so that you can start producing the types of content that moves on these platforms, because it's free to make content, right? Like, I'm sure all of you guys have a phone. I'm sure if you're watching this right now, you're probably watching this on a phone. And to be honest, you can get pretty far with videos and content that you have made on your cell phone or through whatever production means that you have. Most of the time, that is free, guys. It's free to look up keywords. It's free to look up hashtags. It's free to post on Instagram. It's free to post on YouTube. So it comes back to the way that you're producing content and the way that you're getting it out. So I would recommend, like I said, maybe picking about two or three platforms that you're really going to sit down and learn, studying it, figuring it out, and then doing those things in the times where you don't have money to work outside measures like influencers, like playlists, or all of those other things. And secondly, I would recommend that you guys start to build up some type of leverage that you can use in these situations where you don't have any money. So a really good example that I've gotten recently is that in the playlisting world, there are curators who leverage their playlists to get their clients onto bigger playlists. So let's say that I have a 100,000 follower playlist and you have a 100,000 follower playlist, but normally you charge 300 for a post, right? I may come to you and say, hey, I don't have 300 for a post, but I also have a playlist as well. How about this? You put my song in your top 10 and you can send people my way and I'll put them in my top 10. And then you're using that leverage to continuously build yourself up with relationships that you built that don't really require you to spend any money. And it doesn't stop at a playlist. You can do this with meme pages, or I would even suggest that you guys focus on building up your own following, because as an artist, that is the main piece of leverage that you have. Like, you would be surprised at what influencers, at what pages you can get to post you, at what people who would want to work with you when they see that you have a dedicated fan base and a following that you can leverage. And more often than not, it doesn't even have to be a very large following. It just needs to be an engaged following that's going to go engage with the content when these other pages post you or talk about you or whatever things that you're doing. And in the music industry, leverage is a lot. Leverage is oftentimes the difference between being stuck in a rut, being stuck at a certain place, and then truly being able to advance yourself, like I said, in the times when you don't even have money to spend on the things that you know you need to do to advance yourself. And lastly, guys, I know this one isn't really a marketing trick. It's not really a technique, but it is very valuable information. It's what I often tell people who hit me up in my DMs and say, hey, I don't have a budget to do these things that you and Sean and all of these other people are talking about. And what I tell them is to just save, man. Like, even the brokest of broke boys can find some money to put to the side and eventually build up into a respectable, sizable budget that you can use for these things that you know you need to be doing. So while you're doubling down on your content production, while you're figuring out what platforms you're going to work, while you're figuring out what types of content you're going to post on these platforms, while you're finding your hashtags, while you're finding your keywords, while you're finding your groove and your posting schedule, use that time to build up and save up a budget. You can put even $20 a month to the side and eventually eventually get to a point, it is still better than nothing. Pretty much, if you have no budget, but you still want to keep the ball moving, like I said, double down on your content production, double down on the platforms that you're going to promote yourself on. Really dig into that stuff because that is free. Content production is free. Engaging with your fans and engaging with other people on these platforms is free. And then you want to use that time to actually save money, stack your bread up, and build up a budget that you can use to do the stuff that's going to really get the ball moving. And before I end this video, I want to hear you guys' thoughts on what are the things that you're doing in these times that you don't have any money, right? Like, what are you doing to continuously advance yourself in your marketing when you're going through a period of broke boyness? Because it happens to all of us. You know, I got some Facebook ads right now I should be running, but you know, money ain't been a little tight, so we gotta get that together. So drop those in the comment section below. Help some of your fellow artists out so we can all keep continuing, so that we can all keep progressing. Now, as always, guys, if you feel like you learned anything today, please like and share this video. Hit those post notifications, as well as I wouldn't want you guys to miss anything. Once again, my name is Corey, and I'll see y'all next time.